Hello everyone. In this lecture, we will see how to write array of structure. So you know what is mean by array and what is mean by structure. So array is a collection of variables having same data type, and structure is a collection of variables having different data types. What we have to do here is we have to declare a structure, and by considering that structure as a variable, we have to create array of such structures. So you have to create a structure, and by considering structure as a variable, you have to declare array of such structure. Okay, so we will start with it. We will write a program here that we will take data of an employee, and we will write the program to enter data of 5 employees and print it. Okay, so first of all, I need to declare one structure. For that, I'm having the syntax like struct is the keyword. You have to give the name to the structure. Suppose I'm giving name as an employee. Inside this structure, you have to write the variables which you want to declare for the structure employee. Suppose I'm taking integer employee ID, first variable, employee ID, and second, suppose float salary we are considering, right? So these are two variables we have declared inside a structure. So the name of structure is employee, and total two variables are there inside employee, or we can say data items for employee. The total size of employee is, as employee ID is of integer type, it will require 2 bytes of memory, and as float salary is there, it will require 4 bytes. So total 6 bytes of memory employee structure will require. What we have to do is, here we have to create one structure variable so that we can retrieve the whole structure. Now, in previous lecture, what we have did, we have declared one variable, right? Now I'm declaring the variable named E here. But in today's session, what we have to see is array of such structure. So consider this whole structure as a variable now. Okay. So this structure contains different types of variables. But now consider this whole structure as a variable and create array of such variable. Now this is the variable. Okay, we are accessing this variable by using E. Now I am going to create array of such structure. Okay, so suppose 5 I am writing. So what it means, now E is the variable for the structure employee, right? And I am creating the array. So 5 is the size. Now suppose only one variable of employee requires 6 bytes of memory. So total this structure now requires 6 into 5. Total 30 bytes of memory it requires now. Okay. So this is the declaration of structure. Now what I have to do is, I have to enter the data for 5 employees and I have to print the data. Now as I'm working with the array, I need one variable so that it can work for the for loop. Okay. So I'm declaring a variable integer I. I'm simply writing a printf statement here to indicate that enter data for 5 employees. Only I'm printing a simple message so that I can understand what work I have to do here, right? Okay. So by using scanf statement, we are entering the data, right? So before that, you have to write the for loop, because now we are working with array. So I is equal to 0. I less than 5 and I plus plus. So this is the simple logic of for. Inside this for, you have to write the scanf statement. Okay. So scanf, see, in single scanf only I am entering the data for ID and salary. Okay. So first I am entering ID means %d I have to use, and after that I am using or entering salary means I have to write %year. Okay. So comma. Now see, in previous lecture what we have did, or when we are not working with array of structure, we were working with simple structures. At that time we have written that e dot employee id and comma e dot salary, right? But here we are working with array. So what we have to write here is e of I, right? Before that we have to write address of operator, as we are working with the scanf here, right? So e of I dot employee id comma address of e of I dot salary, right? So what we have did, see here, in scanf statement, first I need to enter employee ID. So I have taken %d. After that, I have to enter salary of employee. That for that I am entering or writing %f here. Instead of writing only e dot employee ID, I am taking e of I dot employee ID. What it I indicates, initially the value of I is 0. So whatever the data you entered for I is equal to 0. So e of 0, e of 0. For the zeroth number of employee, you are entering the data. After that, value of I will be incremented. It will be 1. So e of 1 dot employee ID, e of 1 dot salary. So whatever the data you have entered for second time, that will be the first employee. Means actually it is second employee. Likewise, you have to enter the data for 5 times, as we have given I less than 5 and employee size is 5, right? So you have to enter the data for 5 times and accordingly it will save onto the memory. Okay, so by using this for loop, we are entering the data for 5 employees, right? Now what we have to do is we have to print the same data. For that I am writing here one printf statement, simple message that slash n we can write anything here. So I am writing the data is, okay, the data is, and after that I'm simply copying this for loop and pasting here and making the corrections here only. So instead of scanf I need to write printf here, as I'm printing the data. So we cannot use address of operator here, we cannot use address of operator here. So for %d e of I dot employee id and for %f e of I dot salary. So this is the simple program. Now see whether it will work or not. Yes, it's working. Enter data for 5 employees. Okay. So for employee ID 1, I'm entering the salary, suppose this much. For employee ID 2, I am entering the salary like this. For employee 3, I am entering the salary like this. For employee 4, I am entering the salary like this. And for employee 5, I am entering the salary like this. Now see, okay. So the data is, see, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. So we are taking float here. For that purpose, it is showing like 1111.0000. Okay, so if we are using slash n here, so it will print the data in new line every time. Okay, now check whether it will work efficiently or not. Yes, it's working. Okay, so first employee, employee ID is 1 and I'm taking salary as this much. For second employee, employee ID is 2, salary is this. For 3, it's like this. For 4, it's like this. For 5, it's like this. It's printing. The data is, the data is whatever we have entered here, it is showing properly. So once again I will explain the program. So here we have declared one structure. For that we have to use the keyword struct. The name of structure is employee. It contains total 2 data items. One is type of integer, one is type of float. And we have declared the array of such structure. The array size or total data items present in array is 5, right? So after that For entering the data, we are using a for loop, and we are taking five elements here, or five employees data here, and simply we are printing that data. Thank you.